the background.
Are you doing this right now? I'm about, or I'm about to have a grubby bong out there.
It's already recording. We can leave that in.
Yeah, that's
fine. Do you know where the mouse is at? Hello, everyone.
Hi, everyone.
We're not live, don't worry. Well, let me go back to, let's recap some things that we just witnessed of Doctor Who. Yeah. Which episode was that, Dan?
That was episode one. So the Christmas special is usually what?
The transition.
The transition.
Yeah. Let me get the audio a bit better.
But this is very, this is Capaldi's very first entrance.
Okay.
So what you saw was the tickle and the taste of his first episode.
Yeah,
and
yeah.
As you can see, he already did, what, three monologues? three monologues?
Yeah, I have got some things to say. I'm just making a tobacco, everybody.
Because they make him sort of forget his time jump, because he's inside a dinosaur. He said, "Oh, that's just usually unusual."
unusual.
Well, the exterior of the box is the where the wood kind of touches the air, I guess. That boundary is when the TARDIS time warps everything.
Yeah.
Everything that's out of that orb, it doesn't expand. There's only been a couple of episodes in the past where that sort of happened, where he was able to expand the field, containment field of around the TARDIS.
Yeah.
I
have some complaints.
Yeah.
I have some complaints. So what season is this?
This is season 9, series 8. So that would be the 9th Doctor.
Series 8, episode 1, Deep Breath, which I need to take. It's woke, okay?
Oh,
so, that's unfortunate. So this is the burgeoning, this is the beginning of the woke, maybe, or... Maybe it started early. Well, I know it started early.
It started earlier. I think personally, I think even all the
Tennet? Matt Smith coughing, everyone.
There's always some agenda that they're sort of
to explore. Okay.
While the originals like try to explore a lot of concepts, like what Capaldi's just done, he tried to sort of talk about the discovery of self and like what happens if you don't understand yourself and who you are and.
Mm.
So they sort of tried to touch on, you know, him having to remember who these people were around him.
So my complaint the stage right. for you to understand. I watched Tennant, David Tennant.
Yep.
And he is like the GOAT for me. He's like the best me.
Of course.
I love him. He's such a great actor. He is the Doctor.
Mm-hmm.
But then you have just introduced me. My friend here has just introduced me to not only Capaldi, we watched Capaldi first, we put on an episode, and I was enchanted by his performance. But then I said, no, I can't start from here. I need to go to Matt Smith and watch on from there. And that's what I did. So the episode, there is stark comparison from the episode that I watched with you to this one.
Course,
yeah. I'm guessing it changes over the season or evolves over the season. Yeah.
They sort of each sort of essence of each Doctor. So like the first one was sort of jokey, adventurous. Used a lot of humor. Where the next Doctor used a lot of action and movement and. Yeah, and I think the Matt Smith one did a lot more fun to be around more kids.
So that's what I want to say.
So he was a really good one to sort of explore your imagination side of what the Doctor Who sort of means.
We've got some Best of Doctor Who soundtrack on right now just to help us.
This is a really good one.
This is a great song. I don't know if I've heard this song. This is Murray Gold. I've heard that name before.
I think a lot of music in quite of their inspirational moments in Doctor Who.
Beautiful music in Doctor Who. Absolutely
sort of,
beautiful. I don't know the composers. I'll look them up. Thank you to those composers. Beautiful music. playful music. Listen to this, you know. But I prefer Matt Smith to Capaldi. at least right now, as I sit, because Matt Smith has a more vibrant youth energy to him, and Capaldi just then, and I hate to say this, I hate to say this, man, but like Capaldi in some of those monologues, it fell a bit flat, and I think if I was a director, I would have said 10% more, 10% more, a bit more, and I would have, like. He's obviously a great actor, and we've talked about him before in other videos. Me and my friend, can I say your name? Me and my friend Dan, you know, and we've talked about Capaldi. He is good. I'm not taking that away from him or anything. Like he's good, but it just didn't hit the same as Matt Smith or David Tennant. And right now I'm totally in a Matt Smith. He's so hot right now. Like, he's the hot commodity.
His gay raider is fucking getting triggered.
Yeah, hey, shush. So, because I've been watching him in House of the Dragon, and he's so good as Daemon. And now, it's seeing him as the Doctor is such a... He's so different. He's younger. He's so exciting and fun to watch. Capaldi, okay, so I have made my complaints. I said that his acting was, I would have gone in a different direction and like pushed him even more and got him to just be over the top even more. I'm going to continue to watch though, because I want to watch finish Matt Smith's run. And also Capaldi's, and then I'll have this great view of three good seasons, at least to my knowledge, of Doctor Who. I've just been watching this guy. He smokes pipes, and he has to stoke it. And I just have to relight here. I didn't even get to my second complaint, so I'll get to my second complaint, which is the wokeness. Well, I mentioned it, but I didn't get into it. The wokeness, immediately, there are... girls everywhere, which is cool, right? But they're all like totally gay with each other. They're the girl bosses, and there's even, what was that line, Dan?
Yeah.
What was that line that not all humans are apes, men are monkeys?
That's correct.
There was so many cheap shots at men, and it is so see-through.
By the whole cast of women in that scene, the comment was made, and then everyone was sat there in silence, which might as well have said, we agree. True?
Yes, that scene where they're just sitting and talking about how men are bad.
That's correct.
This scene. Oh, this is a good song. The Doctor's theme. Where is it where they're sitting and talking and he's just talking about... Is it here?
Yes. And after we find out that the human here is a slave to a lizard.
Yeah, and like...
They're playing Dominic.
Is it just me or is she older, the lizard lady? She's like a cougar. She's like a lesbian cougar.
That's right.
What is going on?
Praying on the young female. She's a female
cougar. She's a groomer
lesbian.
Cougar.
That's right.
She's a groomer cougar.
And she uses
this bitch. Oh, I shouldn't say. This girl is
Clara
is like a resting bitch face girl. She's so mean.
Yes.
She's not likable. She's like mean spirited. I didn't pay attention to this scene. Capaldi doing his thing. He is good. You understand how I'm like not trying to take away from his acting ability. He is good. I just would have. There's just on one of his monologues, he fell a bit flat. That's the truth. I did a bad monologue in my acting class once, and it really embarrassed me. Someone clapped before it had ended, and I got really distracted, and I forgot my lines, and it was
now,
a wreck.
What do you think of the evil character here? What do you think of their creation? I mean, I think they did a really good job.
One thing I noticed is the actor who plays him is good. What is it? Who is he? What is his name?
No idea.
The robot guy, I would hand this around so you could see. But then I have to write a copyright and shit like that.
Well, you can use 10% of the material. You just can't.
What'd you ask? What I think? Yeah, the actor is good. I also noticed the CGI. They've put green paint or something on his face, so you can see through to the back of, like, you can see through his face. He's imposing. It reminds me of Bicentennial Man.
Yeah.
When they go through the theme of, it's a robot wanting to be a human. And he's harvesting all the... Yeah, it's scary. It's scary. They go into the restaurant, and it's scary. And, like, the doctor notices that he has two different hands. And it's like, oh, he's cannibalizing. But it comes to a head at the end where he's saying, you've been alive for millions of years. Do you even remember your face? Do you even know where you got this face? And that like, really affects him, the bad guy. That really affects him, yeah. And gets to him, and this sort of like a breakthrough moment,
Which sort of touches on our immortality, you know, So, you know, what would you do if you had all of time to find the promised land?
Would you like to be immortal?
I think it's only humanly nature to want to exist for eternity, especially if.
Oh, interesting.
If it's all the right conditions, like. No, I'm thankful that we get to fucking die, because imagine this for all eternity.
I'd like to have the option to live forever, but choose when to die. Because after like thousands of or millions of years or something, I might get bored and be like, okay, time to die. That's what I wish it was like, instead of like dying at 80 or because of this, I'm going to die like really early.
we're gonna, and
because I'm like because of this and everything,
we're already fucked. Yeah, this is our poison.
Yeah, event. Yeah. Apparently,
it's this too has late. Saved a billion, you know, brain
it's
cells.
It's not too late, but
and we're already fried.
Well, he's not wrong.
So I thought on a philosophical approach to what they tried to produce on the content. Was sort of, you know, interesting. Cause, you know,
I liked his theme. I liked his art.
Capaldi's, throughout the whole season, is known for trying to be
existential, yeah.
Crisis.
Yeah, because he's because he's older.
That's right. Yeah. So they go through a much more deep.
We actually do get to see Matt Smith, and he talks about how his fear is being old.
Which really sort of ties in a full circle.
Here's a monologue
because
right
here
now.
He is exploring the thing he's most fearful of.
Oh, this fucking
now,
lizard
I'm not too
bitch.
Sure if you know about some of the lore of the Doctor's time capsule. So there's parts of this will make you sort of question whether all of this has been happening inside a time capsule. So there's an episode where he gets trapped in a time capsule.
It's like a question from
and
then
it's,
on
no,
out.
It's sort of a Gallifreyan gadget that allows all time doctors to quite literally... explore themselves.
Yeah, so you're saying like this could all be a dream, like
correct
yeah,
in
yeah,
reality.
Yeah.
But that
I'm not aware of that. No
contrast of the.
But you could say that about Star Trek episodes, like they could still be in the holodeck the whole time.
Exactly.
That is a really good comparison.
That's
yeah.
exactly what the
Nah, I accept this is happening.
Mm.
That's what I think. That's what I reckon. But. I'll see you in the next episode. I don't know. It could be a delusion or whatever. It is my delusion, Corey. Good. It is
well,
my delusion.
Well, I think a part of a good story is to tell a mysterious story, parts and element to a story where you sort of leave it to future places, but you're putting down some of the lore or some of the world building, if you will.
Yeah. Can we just let's just turn this up for a second and see if you can hear this. I'm just filming.
I'm going to bed.
Okay.
Happy birthday. In an hour's time.
Oh, thank you. Thank you for that.
Yeah.
Well, I'll be up tomorrow.
Yeah, make sure you don't sleep all night.
No.
Make sure you wake him up early for breakfast.
Yeah. Well, I'll be at work, but I will when I get home. Anyways,
night, mate.
Good night. Is it Thursday?
Thursday tomorrow. Thank you.
Actually, you've got another 5 hours, 6 hours before. before you're born.
Yeah. What time was it exactly?
5:25.
Ah, 5:25 I was born. All right, thank you for that. Night night. That's funny. That's funny. That's classic. I'm gonna leave most of that in, guys. That's just classic. That's my dad. He looks after me. I'll talk about him in other videos. He's great. He looks after me and stuff. There's things we'll talk about. Yeah. Anyway. Well, oh yeah. I wanted to listen to Matt Smith here.
Hello. Hello?
It's me.
Yes, it's you. Who's this?
It's me, Clara. The doctor.
What do you mean, the doctor?
I'm phoning you from Trenzalore.
From before I changed.
I mean, it's all still to happen for me, coming. Oh, it's coming.
Not long now.
I can feel it.
Why?
Not very good, right?
Why did you do this?
But he's good. This is like, this moment is great.
And I think you might be scared.
And however scared you are, Clara, you are with right now.
Well, she can't cry on command, so.
You are with. Believe me, he is more scared than anything you can imagine right now.
Yeah, it's like, oh, I've got to be so sad that he's calling, oh, I'm losing him.
Well, no, it's just such a, it's a fantastic moment. This is such a clever idea, and she just, I don't know, she's just not a good actress, I'm sorry.
She sounds old.
Please tell me I didn't get old.
This is acting. That is acting.
I was young.
Look at these expressions and...
Yes?
Clara, please. Hey, for me.
Music, excellent music. Help him.
Go on.
Beautiful moment. Character moment.
And don't
especially
be
this, yeah, for sure.
Afraid.
She's just sort of observing the situation.
Goodbye, Clara.
Yeah. Look at that.
Well, she was talking the whole episode about how she missed this doctor.
That's what
and
loved it. And was in shock that, you know, that's what they were portraying.
And then he turned into this old dude.
And then he said, you wasn't a good boyfriend. What are you talking about?
Yeah.
Which was a good, because it was just a character moment that was just like, well, what gave you of that inclination?
Yeah.
You
know? Well, what?
And he's...
He asked you a question.
Here we go.
Will you help me?
You shouldn't have been listening.
I was and I didn't need to. That was me talking.
Uh-huh. Timey-wimey stuff.
You can't see me, can you? You look at me and you can't see me.
That's... You know what this is good.
Like?
That's good. Boom.
I'm not on the phone. I'm right here. Standing in front of you. Please, just see me.
The guy awkward he is. He's funny. He's got funny chops. He does.
This isn't my home, by the way.
Sorry. I'm sorry about that. I missed.
Where are we?
Glasgow, I think.
Ah, you'll fit right in. Squash.
Total British stuff.
Yeah,
I love it.
British soap opera. I love it.
Do you want to go get some?
Yeah, it has that feel. It has the British feel to it, the air of the of Britishness. Just look at that, look at that visual there. That's so British.
It's so British.
I don't have any money.
You're fetching then.
I'm not sure that I'm the fetching.
A very modernized version of it.
Still not sure.
It's got to have a place, have a meaning, just be organized. It's so strange.
Oh, I actually really like this bit. This hopefully you can hear this.
I think the entrance of the master has been very well done here. She's just like, how can I bullshit him?
I miss it.
It's great.
You made it. I hope my boyfriend wasn't too mean to you.
Is that what his, what's his name?
Friend.
Now, did he push you out of that thing?
Name, your name?
Or did you fall?
That's the master.
Couldn't really tell.
The bad guy, him.
He can be very
mean
sometimes.
Okay.
But she's the master? She's the master.
Oh, I thought the master was a he.
No.
A shit. Oh,
in
I do like his new
previous series.
Oh, that's okay. I didn't know any of this.
The master.
Look, you can see through his face. That's what I was talking about.
Yeah, yeah.
Yeah.
Where do you think you are?
Gone. Gone. Sorry.
You made it. The promised land.
What was that?
Welcome to heaven.
So the master is, yeah, the yin yang version, you know,
the
dark,
polar opposite sort of
polar
thing.
Polar opposite of what?
Yeah, the evil twin sort of thing.
That's correct. The evil twin that explores darkness, explores, you know,
the shadow.
The shadow side. So it's very well articulated, the doctor and the law. So, like, don't get me wrong, David Tennet did some absolute wonderful concept building and world building.
Yes.
So we can't judge, you know, his creativity in the expansion of Doctor Who, but it was just very sad of how he's starting this era, coming back to the show, totally woke, totally feminized, weaponized by femininity, and disability, I don't know, fucking just...
Russell T. Davies not wanting to have... No, is it
to explore the depth of the diversity of what characters can sort of bring to the work?
Mm.
I mean, look at the lizard ladies. That gives really great you know, exploration of another species, like what you know, the exploration of new species that Star Trek and Star Wars discover. You know,
Stephen Moffat, Brian. Okay, well, that was the episode, and yeah, I just think. I had those couple of complaints, but there was some great things too. Like, I'm going to watch it. I'm going to keep on watching because I want to see Peter Capaldi do his thing as the Doctor, who is growing on me, you know. Like, it is... I just want to get a nice picture so we can look at just of his face or something. I don't know. That's pretty cool. Yeah, so I'm going to go back and watch Matt Smith's run and finish it. I've just watched a great episode of his where the Weeping Angels, they go to a planet and there's a crashed ship and they find all these statues and they all start turning into Weeping Angels and they're coming after them and the lights are going out and they've got, one of them is talking over the radio. It's real freaky. It's a great episode. And that's like what I got off, so I'm going to keep on going from there. But yeah, so more Doctor Who stuff ahead, because I'm watching all the retro ones. And I'll keep on making videos. So thank you for watching, and thank you to Dan for joining us. Dan says goodbye. Okay, bye everyone. Bye-bye.